good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we are diving into some brand new WWE action figure news for you guys. If you guys did not see this, it's actually kind of insane. I'll get into the story just a little bit here. But we had WWE Elite Series 89 revealed to us. You know, all we saw before were just renders. We saw a couple prototypes here and there, and, you know, we didn't really know what to fully expect out of this wave. But I think you guys are going to be pleasantly surprised because this wave looks really insane. Probably, I don't know, in terms of, like, quality of figure, I mean, this one's pretty good, I would say. I mean, there's one little dudsy in there, which we'll get into, of course, when we cover the wave. But this thing looks insane, man. Can't wait to dive into it. But it was kind of weird the way they were revealed because, you know, Ringside Collectibles is usually the first people to post stuff. But this time, it was actually a different website that posted up the images. And then it started sharing everywhere. And then Ringside came in maybe an hour or two later, or maybe a few hours later, and posted theirs up. It was a very odd thing. And they posted them up, and they look pretty damn good, man. So let's just go ahead and dive in, man. Starting out first, let's start off with Elite Series 89 Damian Priest. Now, a lot of people are thrilled about this figure, and I think that's a really good thing because this figure looks great. I really like it. While I'm not the biggest, I don't know what I was saying there, I guess because I was thinking of Priest. While I'm not the biggest Damian Priest fan, man, this figure looks very, very good. Like, I love the way it looks. I love the texture that we're getting on the crotch mold. I love the texture that we're getting on the legs. It does look like this is going to be like an edge crotch and legs with some added details and added sculpts on there with the metal netting and stuff like that. Great open knee pads on there. The purple attire looks great. I would have preferred the white gear, but, you know, I can accept it here. Maybe if he was the Chase variant. He is not the Chase variant in this set. Very upsetting, but he is in his purple gear, and his gauntlets look really good. I've heard a lot of people tell me that they think the gauntlets are a bit bulky, which they probably are a bit bulky, but I think it looks great. I like the, you know, you could use that for other customs or maybe some other people. And the torso looks great. Head sculpt looks great. The vest, you have all these different things going on with it. So I really like the Damian Priest. The tattoos look good, and I love it. I think it looks really, really good. Hopefully the articulation and the posability is really good. But another thing I wanted to add as we look at the in-package image here is for some reason I was imagining that the blue and red packaging, or the blue and red colorway, would just be for the Top Picks wave. You guys remember we reviewed that. If you guys missed the Top Picks 2022 wave, they had this new packaging for us with Jeff Hardy, Goldberg, and Roman Reigns. And I thought for sure that this would only be for the Top Picks. Like, I knew the box style would be the same with the logo and the Elite Collection and the name and everything. I knew the fonts and all that stuff would be the same. But for some reason, I imagined the colors. Like, I didn't think that the blue would be in there. I thought it would be more white and red centric, or maybe like gray, or I don't know. I don't know what I was thinking, but it's definitely not what I expected as far as the colors of the box. But Damian Priest looks really good in there. Love the way it came out. And this Elite packaging is something we're going to have to get used to. So moving on next, guys, let's get into Dominic Mysterio. Now, you guys are going to immediately notice that he is going to be matching his father, Elite Series 88 Rey Mysterio. But Dom seems to be a little bit better, in my opinion, man. Figure looks really damn good. I'd say head to toe looks just like him. I mean, to be honest, arms are probably a little too jacked. Like, but this is pretty much, I mean, the standard for arms on a wrestling figure. I mean, besides giving him, like, Jungle Boy or, you know, even James Ellsworth arms, which would be really odd looking. Like, his arms aren't this cut. They're not that big. They don't have that much muscle, all that stuff. But the figure still looks immaculate. I love the chest that they're using, or the torso that they're using. I like the attire that they're going with. Another thing that you could have said is maybe, you know, give him the Chase figure and give him his debut gear if you wanted to, and the blue and black would be really cool. But head sculpt looks really good. Tattoos look nice. It looks just like him, and I'm not the biggest Dominic Mysterio fan of any sorts, but really cool figure. You know, you could do a lot of stuff with this. You could play around with it. You know, you can pair him up with Rey Mysterio or something like that. You get the kendo stick accessory of absolutely. You know, you gotta have that. So the Dom looks really cool. I like it. And I want to say, I could be mistaken, but I want to say that the crotch piece down is Seth Rollins' leg, so he's gonna be on ball joints, and maybe you could torso crack it and make a cool Seth Rollins or something. I don't know, but the Dominic Mysterio looks good. I love the colorway and everything like that going on with it. Head sculpt looks great. Looks good in package and everything. And I will say, I feel like the top left corner WWE thing right there, I could see where people get annoyed by that on the packaging. However, at the same time, you know, it doesn't bother me that much. But I think it can, like, cover up the figure a little bit sometimes. So, there's the Dominic, man. Let's move on to Nia Jax. We have Nia Jax. We have the regular version in red, and then we have the Chase variant version. And this is one of the figures that I wanted to gripe about, man, because the head sculpt, you're going to notice. The head sculpt looks fantastic, right? It's a great-looking head sculpt. I love the way that the head sculpt looks. It looks just like her. I think it captures her likeness very, very well. But it also comes with the Women's Tag Team Championship, the other side of the Elite 82, Alexa Bliss, if I'm not mistaken. Seven series between that is a little bit odd for me. I feel like one to two series is probably how much of a gap there should be, especially, like, seven series, bro? That's a long time. Like, that's like a year almost between the two. So, the thing that I'm going to notice immediately, now, I want to say that these sleeves may be new, like, the way they've sculpted this sleeve right here at the elbow with the little piece right there in gold. But you guys will notice that she has single jointed arms and knees. So that means that this figure is literally like her first basic, which was so long ago, man. The Elite 65 Nia Jax had single jointed arms and the same knees with a single joint. So, I mean, that's kind of disappointing, man. That's a long time. That's like almost 25 series. That was like 2.5, 3 years ago, maybe even 3.5 years ago that we saw this body mold. So to see that repeated here for her new figure is pretty disappointing. I feel like they could have at least gotten double jointed knees in there for the figure. That just means they haven't really tooled it or spent the time on retooling that, which is kind of disappointing, like I said. But, I mean, it looks good as a standard Nia Jax figure. I don't like Nia Jax. I don't like her character. I don't like her in the ring. She it really just makes me drive up the wall. But the head sculpt looks really good. It's a good update, I guess. But I don't think this is a must grab because her last Elite was pretty much this with different heads. And it gives you more options. So there's that. But you do get the new Women's Tag Team Championship to go with your other one if you were interested in that. But this figure is completely skippable, in my opinion, if you wanted to do so. Now, let's get back on the brighter side of things, man. Let's dive into this freaking Bobby Lashley, man. Bobby Lashley looks great, man. I really like the head sculpt. I love the double-jointed arms. Like, it's just insane to even see double-jointed arms. I don't know if they were planning on implementing that before the AEW figures came along. I'm not sure if it was, you know, I want to say they were, you know, maybe they had an idea. But remember, it was just with Ultimates. I don't know if they ever plan to bring it to their main Elite line, but the Bobby Lashley figure looks really good, man. I like the Hurt Business gear. You have like the, I feel like the gold may be a bit bronzy looking, if I'm not mistaken. It kind of looks bronzy to me. I feel like it could probably be a little bit more yellow or goldy looking, but the attire looks great. I love that, you know, they use the same body mold. Another thing you guys might notice is not only are we getting long tights Lashley, not only are we getting pissed off Lashley, but we're getting new boot molds for this Lashley. Look at it right there, man. The new boot mold with all of his different straps on there. They didn't reuse any boots. They didn't give him the Lesnar boots. They actually tooled his right boots, which is so sick because this can go on a lot of guys. You can put this on Booker T, on a Drew McIntyre. You could even put it on a Batista. Like, there's a lot of guys you could put this on, and it looks great. I love the way the boots came out. Super happy for that. And another guy that I would have loved to see be the Chase variant, man. I feel like that's a very big missed opportunity not to have one of these other guys be the Chase variant over Nia Jax, especially when the Nia Jax doesn't have the updated articulation. I feel like, you know, a Bobby Lashley or Drew McIntyre or Dom or even, you know, Damian Priest would have been a much better Chase figure. But the Hurt Business Bobby Lashley looks really great. You get the WWE Championship, which looks good. Seen that for quite a while now, so really big moves right here with the Bobby Lashley. But dude, look at this Drew McIntyre. This Drew McIntyre looks so damn good. Now, I will say, you might could switch out the torso if you wanted to for a different torso. I know a lot of people have a problem with this torso for Drew, because if you look on the back of the packaging, you'll notice that, like, he's clearly not this cut. However, I mean, he does have a prominent chest, and maybe the shape of it is a little bit off because it's a little bit too vertical compared to or wide. Like, the width versus the length, I think, is something that a bunch of people have a problem with. But the head sculpt, man, this head sculpt looks phenomenal. Arms look great. I love the gauntlets we're getting. Get the entrance kilt there with the sword. I mean, dude, this is a really good-looking figure. I think this is probably the best Drew they've made to date. Even though I prefer my Drew to be a heel, I really like the haircut this one's got. Really great-looking figure, man. Just an excellent figure here, and I love the way Drew came out. So Drew's going to be making his way there. And I don't know. I can't tell if this is the... I feel like this is the newer skin tone. It just doesn't look as dark as the other ones have been, at least in these photos. I'm sure it's the same skin tone, but I think that the Drew McIntyre looks absolutely fantastic. And so, not only do we have Drew, man, rounding out the set, we do have Sergeant Slaughter. Now, a lot of people are upset that this Sergeant Slaughter is missing a couple details. Now, I can't tell you exactly what those details are at this moment, but he does have one of the Ultimate Edition head sculpts, I do believe. He's got his entrance jacket, he's got red elbow pads, his hat, his sunglasses. He comes with a pretty good amount of accessories, which is nice to see. And I love the, not the camo, but the khaki colored pants look really good, and I like the khaki jacket to go along with your, you know, your Collector's Edition Colonel Mustafa. So that is something right there that you can pair together there. And it's just so cool to see this, man. I like to see flashbacks, especially in the modern times here with the modern line and everything like that. So, I don't know, man. I like all of the different figures. Besides the Nia Jax, I think the Nia Jax is the worst. Like, if I had to rank these before I get them in hand, it would be kind of difficult, man. Because I think the wave is super-duper strong. And so, that is one thing to mention. But let me know down below, man. What do you think of Elite Series 89? I'm hoping that I will have these to review for you guys very soon. I don't know how soon those reviews will start. But I want to say that they should be within the next 3 or 4 days. I should have these in hand to start reviewing. So we'll have to see about that. I want to review. I don't know. Let me know down below which ones you want to see me review first, man. But I think the wave looks really good. I'm excited to get back into review season and stuff like that. But that is pretty much going to wrap up our coverage of Elite Series 89, man. Thank you guys so very much for watching. If you guys missed Vindication Episode 17 posted yesterday, please go check it out. I would greatly appreciate it. It would mean a lot to me, man. But thank you guys for watching. Subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok at MyDamnToys. And I will see you guys in the next video. Don't cross the line like the Nia Jax figure. You crossed the line.